गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। इन ज्योग्राफी द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर विल बी टॉट टू यू इन दिस वीडियो, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 6, मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज। अर्लियर चैप्टर दैट इज मिनरल्स, इट विल नॉट कम इन बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन, ओनली मैप विल बी आस्क्ड फ्रॉम दैट चैप्टर। सो वट एवर विल बी आस्क्ड आई विल टेल यू इन सीक्वेंस, you should not be worried about that. This chapter should be taught to you for the preparation of board examination, and I think you should keep your book with you. Important terms will be coming and you will be listening them carefully. Manufacturing industries, first of all you should understand the meaning of manufacturing. Manufacturing means to prepare something where with the help of raw material, when we prepare something to increase its value in the market, and the place where it is prepared, that is called factory industry. And this process, when we prepare something from raw material, that is called manufacturing. What is the importance of manufacturing for us? Actually, 4 or 5 points have been given in your book. Carefully listen them. The first point has been given in your book. Manufacturing industry not only help in modernizing industries, which forms the backbone of our country, they also reduce the heavy dependence of people on agricultural income by providing them jobs in secondary and tertiary sector. Means manufacturing industry, it is not only modernizing the industries, agricultural industry. So many equipments are being prepared, so many tools are being prepared, fertilizers are being prepared, methods to irrigate the field, they are being developed. In this way, agriculture is going to be modernized with the help of manufacturing industries. If industries are there, they are prepared something. For example, jet pumps, they have been prepared in the industry, and fertilizers have been prepared, chemicals have been prepared, pesticides have been prepared. So when people were depend for their employment maximum on agriculture, now manufacturing industry is also giving employment to maximum people in the country. This is the first importance of the manufacturing industries. The second has been given, industrial development is a precondition for eradication of unemployment. If any country wants to remove unemployment from the country, definitely that country will have to open industry in it. If you remember, just after independence, the first Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, supported to open many industries in different parts of India. This is the reason he is called the father of modern India. This is the reason. So different industries have been opened that time. This was necessary for the eradication of unemployment. This was the main philosophy behind public sector industry and joint sector ventures in India. If we want to develop other industries, we have to create the possibility of making industry in the country. Next importance has been given, that export of manufactured goods expands trade and commerce and brings in much needed foreign exchange. When we establish factory in the country, no doubt foreign currency comes in the country, and it is the source of maximum foreign currency if we establish industry in the country. And countries that transform their raw material into wide variety of furnished goods of higher value are prosperous. When we start the work of manufacturing, it enhances our quality of making the things. Whatever quality was earlier there, slowly, slowly, we get efficiency in making different types of tools, instruments and other things. So, एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज प्रोवाइड्स द क्वालिटी इन मेकिंग द थिंग्स इफ वी एस्टेब्लिश इंडस्ट्री इन द कंट्री. सो यू हैव सीन दैट इट हैज गिवन यू सो मेनी स्पान, सो मेनी एरियाज टू डेवलप योर कंट्री. एंड नो डाउट इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन और मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज दे हैव गिवन यू द वे ऑन विच द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज वेरी पॉसिबल. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एग्रीकल्चर एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज दे गो टूगेदर, दे आर नॉट इंडिपेंडेंट, वन इज डिपेंड अपॉन अनदर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, if we want to improve the irrigation methods in country, for that purpose we have to improve the production of pipes, pumps, engines, tractors and other things. These things they are being used in modern day agriculture life. So if manufacturing industry will be strong, it will provide different thing for the use of agriculture in our country. Now the second thing has been given in your book, that if we make good quality instrument in the country, it will increase our quality also of doing agriculture, and globally we will be having the place equal to other foreign countries. This will be the benefit for us. So we can be in the condition to compete with the foreign industries. So it depends upon the manufacturing industries, how they are producing. Next point has been given in your book, that is contribution to Indian economy. What contribution has been given by the industries to Indian economy? What contribution has been given? Over the last two decades, according to your book, the share of manufacturing sector has strengthened at 17% of GDP. Whatever share comes to GDP from all sectors, out of them, at least 17% part is shared by agriculture or industrial sector. Means industries provide 17% share in the GDP of the country. It remains changes. Time to time, it is in changing condition. This is much lower in comparison to some East Asian economies, where it is 25 to 35%. In some countries, the part of manufacturing industry, it is more than India. It is 25 to 35% of GDP, and the desired growth rate over the next decade is 12%. Since 2003, manufacturing is once again growing of the rate of 9 to 10% per annum. Per year, it is sometime increasing to sometime decreasing, but it is sharing into the GDP of the country. With appropriate policy intervenes by the government and renewed efforts by the industry to improve productivity, government time to time trying to improve the quality, the capacity to produce qualitative things, it is increasing. Every year it is observed, and the National Manufacturing Competitiveness Council has been set up with this object to increase, to enhance the quality of manufacturing work. One group has been set up. The name of the group is NMCC, National Manufacturing Competitiveness Council. It means this group is responsible to observe what is the till date progress of the manufacturing sector. It is observing, or sometime it gives a suggestion also to the manufacturing sector. Now the next thing is very important. Setup of industry, it is also playing important part in any country. Where we are going to set up the industry? It means if the location is good, then definitely we will have the profit from it. Location plays an important role for getting benefit from the manufacturing sector. Industrial locations are complex in nature. These are influenced by availability of raw material. If in any area raw material is not available, definitely it will be of no use setting up the manufacturing sector. Labor, if workers are not there, it will affect the setting of establishment of manufacturing sector. And capital, if money we do not have, then it is of no use. Power and market, if we do not have the electricity from which the machines will be running out, and if we do not have the market for selling, definitely these are the important factor which are playing important role in the location of any industry in the country. One word has been given here, that is agglomeration economy. It should be understood by you in a careful manner. What is the meaning of agglomeration economy? It has been given here, agglomeration economy. When we talk about the location of any industry, we should discuss that not only industry is set up in a particular area, but due to the establishment of industry, other small units of industries or work or sectors, they also set up near the big industry. For example, if at any place large or big industry has been set up for cement production, suppose cement industry has been set up in any area, first of all, for easy access to industry, roads are required. If roads are there, definitely people are going to work there. It is very easy to bring and return the things which are being produced inside the industry. Next thing, sometime people come to industry for any work. They search the tea stall, they can search ATM, they can search any bank, they can search the shop of photo estate, they can search any other place for having lunch or breakfast. Hotel is required, rickshaws are required, autos are required, and other convenience for going and coming is required. These sectors which I am talking about means tea stall, restaurant, hotel, photo estate shop, what they are, actually they are also depend till the industry is there. These small units which are also earning near the industrial area, in common together they are making agglomeration economy. Industry is earning, it is another matter. The big industry has been set up, it is earning, it is another matter. But due to the setup of industry, other small units, they are also earning with the industry. If railway station is there at any place, so what things are required? Rickshaws are required, autos are required, buses are required, hotels are required, ATM is required, bank is required, water system is required, and other things are required. People will be going there if these things are there. If railway station is at a lone place, nobody wants to go there because so many works they will be impending due to the unavailability of the other subordinate things. In common, together we can call this like agglomeration economy. One chart has been given in your book. This thing, market linkage with industry, location of industry with market linkage. Some elements are there. If the industry wants to earn profit, some elements are required. First of all, we have to set up industry where raw material is available. It is definitely required. एंड लैंड लेबर कैपिटल एंड अदर थिंग्स इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इट इज रिक्वायर्ड देयर टू सेटअप एनी इंडस्ट्री. आफ्टर सेटिंग अप दीज थिंग्स ट्रांसपोर्टेशन फैसिलिटी इज रिक्वायर्ड टू द फैक्ट्री एंड आफ्टर द प्रोडक्शन थिंग्स आर कमिंग फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्री फ्रॉम द फैक्ट्री ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इज अगेन रिक्वायर्ड एंड इट इज गोइंग टू मार्केट एंड इन मार्केट वॉट वी आर गेटिंग वी आर सेलिंग इट एंड वी आर अर्निंग मनी. सो दिस इज द इंडस्ट्री एंड मार्केट लिंकेज. इंडस्ट्री ऑलवेज डिपेंड अपॉन द मार्केट बिकॉज ऑफ द अर्निंग पर्पज. इफ थिंग्स आर बींग प्रिपेयर्ड ओनली दे आर बींग स्टोर्ड इन गोडाउन सपोज कार्स और मॉडर्न कार्स आर बींग प्रोड्यूस्ड दे आर बींग मेड बट दे आर नॉट बींग सोल्ड. सो वट इज द यूज ऑफ मेकिंग कार्स. मार्केट इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर देम. सो इफ मार्केट इज रिक्वायर्ड देन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन विल बी मस्ट फॉर यू एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन विल बी मस्ट फॉर यू टू टाइम्स. ट्रांसपोर्टेशन फैसिलिटीज आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर गोइंग देयर एंड कमिंग फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्री एंड यू हैव टू गो टू मार्केट और इन मार्केट मनी इज देयर. नेक्स्ट थिंग इफ एनीबडी थिंक्स वट आर द आइडियल कंडीशन फॉर सेटिंग अप इंडस्ट्री. फोर पॉइंट्स हैव बीन गिवन इन योर बुक. द फर्स्ट हैज बीन गिवन कॉस्ट ऑफ ऑब्टेनिंग रॉ मटेरियल. वट एवर प्रॉफिट यू आर गोइंग टू अर्न इट डिपेंड्स हाउ मच रॉ मटेरियल यू हैव यूज और हाउ मच कॉस्टली इट वॉज. इट विल डिसाइड द प्राइस ऑफ द थिंग. सेकेंड थिंग हैज बीन गिवन हेयर cost of production at site. What is the real cost of production at the site means inside the industry. After that price you will decide how much money should be taken from the consumer. The original price it is another and the market price it is another. Next is decision to locate industry at site. The people who want to open industry at any place they should decide that at which place setup of industry would be appropriate, would be suitable. The last is cost of distribution of production. How much money you are spending in the distribution of the things to the market because it also requires money. Cars after being made, after being prepared, they are being sent to market. But the freight, the money which is being used for transportation them, where it will be earned from? It will be earned from the consumer, from the market. So very easy, if we decide how much money should be earned from the market, we have to distribute this cost accordingly. This is the element, these are the elements which are the ideal things, ideal elements for the location of any industry. It is very easy to dear students, now we have to see what is the classification of industries. In class 6 or 7th we have read about it. If you remember, what is the classification of industries mean? How many types of industries are there? The first thing has been given, that is on the basis of source of raw material. Because for industrialization, for making industry, for establishment of industry, raw material is required. Two types of industries are there on the basis of raw material: agro-based or mineral-based. It is very simple to understand those industries which require agricultural product as the raw material. For example, cotton, jute, silk, textile, rubber and sugar, tea, coffee, edible oil. These are the agro-based industries. It means edible things based on crop, based on agriculture. The industries are running there. These industries will be called agro-based industry. Some industries are mineral-based industries. It means minerals are required as the raw material in these types of industries. For example, aluminium, machine, tools, petrochemicals, steel, cement, iron. These are the main industries for mineral-based industries. It means minerals are required as the raw material in these type of industries. Next classification has been given here, that is according to their main role. Sometime basic or key industries which supply their products or raw material to manufacturer other goods, for example iron and steel and copper smelting, aluminium smelting. One example I would like to give you. If in any industry car or rail engine is being prepared, for making car and engine raw material is also required. First of all, you would have need the heavy sheets for that, aluminium sheet or iron sheet. For making railway engine, iron sheets are required. The industry which will provide iron sheet, it will be called key industry. And after bringing iron sheet, the engine will be prepared. For example, at your home, you construct the house and implement or post a large gate in front of your house. This gate, this will be assembled at a place, but the main parts, designings, decorative things, they are coming somewhere else from. The other material, they are coming from somewhere else. Another example, you are buying computer. One place where computer parts are assembled, it is another place. But where the parts are being made, this is another place. Those factors, those industries which are supplying the parts, they will be called key industry. And second is there, consumer industries. Consumer industry means where consumers are directly going and buying and they are using directly. There is no time, there is no need to wait. In railway engine, two steps are there. Seats are coming, workers are preparing, engineers are preparing engine with the help of seats. After that, engine is going to use, two steps. But when we need Colgate, we just go to shop, buy it, and after coming home, we start using it without any suggestion or any requirement. This is called direct consumer industry. So those things which are being prepared directly or for the use of consumer, they are called consumer industries. Other classification has also been given on the basis of capital requirement. How much money is required on this base? Two types of industries are there. Small scale industry and large scale industry. Small scale industry is that industry in which approximately or more than 1 crore rupee is required, up to 1 crore rupees. If a factory is established, it will be coming under the category of small industries, small scale industry. It means very simple. If less or up to 1 crore rupee is used to start the industry, it will be called a small scale industry. And if more than 1 crore rupee is required, if more money is required than 1 crore, then it will be called large scale industry. It is very simple. Next classification has been given, that on the basis of ownership. On the basis of ownership, factories are of different type. The first is, that is public sector. Some industries, they are owned by the government. They are called public sector. For example, VEL, BHEL, Bharat Heavy Electrical Limited, SAIL, Steel Authority of India Limited. These are the two examples of public sector industry. Next is, if the industries are owned by private or individuals, they will be called private sector industries. For example, it is given here, TISCO, Tata Steel and Corporation, TISCO, it is in Jamshedpur, and Bajaj Auto Limited, Dabur Industries. These are the example of private industries. Next type of industry is there, that is joint sector. Two are clear. The industries which are owned by the government, run by the government, they are called government industry or public industry, public sector. If the industries are owned by any individual or group of people individually, they are called private sector. If both the sectors, public and the private, they are running any industry, it will be called the industry based on joint sector. It will be called joint sector industry. For example, Oil India Limited. Government decides how to bring the oil from other country, and other distribution is determined by the individual industries in the country. Two parts are there. So this is called joint sector industry. Next is cooperative industries. Industry in which people cooperate to produce the thing and earn money. Money is distributed equally among the people who are busy in the sector. For example, dairy work, sugar production. This is called cooperative industry in the country. The last is waste. The classification is given the based on bulk and weight of raw material. Those industries which require lightweight raw material in measurement, in scale. If the industries require light material, they will be called lightweight industries. Or those industries which require heavy material, which have weight, they will be called heavy industries such as iron and steel. So you have seen that five types of industries are there on the basis of their classification and according to their work and their responsibility. They have been given here. It is very easy to learn on the basis of ownership, on the basis of money, capital used in it, on the basis of bulk and weight, on the basis of ownership. So many things are there. You can read it easily. Dear students, just we have seen the classification of the industries. And the industries have been classified on different types of basis. Now you will see, according to classification, you have to observe that in which type of sector, what type of industries are coming. First we will start, they are agro-based industries. It means industries based on agriculture. Agro-based industries have been given here. They are four in number in your book. Textile industry, cotton industry, jute industry and sugar industry. These all industries are based on agriculture. Textile means preparation of garments. Garments are prepared with the yarn. Yarn are coming from the plant, whether they are the silk yarn or cotton yarn. And in this way, we will read about these types of industries which are called agro-based industries. Textile industry occupies unique position in the Indian economy. Generally, every person wears cloth. Without cloth, life is not possible. So, we are depend upon the production of cloth because it contributes significantly to industrial production. 14% contribution it gives to Indian economy, and it is also giving employment. Maximum people are involved, are busy in textile industries. So, the second largest after agriculture, this is the second largest sector after agriculture, and it also gives you chance to earn foreign exchange, and it contributes 4% towards GDP. Out of whole 4% GDP comes from textile industries. And when we talk about it, we have to see how the garments are prepared. One link has been given in your book above here. See what has been given here. First of all, we arrange raw fiber, raw material, and from raw fiber we prepare fiber production. After that we go to spinning, and then yarn is prepared. After that yarn is going under the process of weaving, fabric is prepared, and after that we make it colorful and we manufacture the garments, and then garments are prepared and they are sold to market. This is the whole process of making garments in any textile industry. Next industry is that cotton textile. Especially we will talk about the cotton production in India. In board examination, one of the agro-based industry can be asked. You should prepare at least 2 agro-based industries for your board examination. I suggest you that you should prepare cotton industry, cotton textile industry. It is having lengthy material content, and so many things are there. You can write the answer in a sufficient content. In ancient India, cotton textile were produced with hand spinning and hand loom weaving techniques. After the 18th century, power looms came into use. Earlier, handmade cloths were there. People were weaving the cloths into the blazes. And after that, machines have come. When machines have come, people started using machines. And for machines, power was required. So, these machines, that is the reason they are called power looms. For running machines, power is required to run them. As on 30 November 2011, there were 1946 cotton and human-made fiber textile mills in India. About 80% of these are in the private sector and others are in the public sector. Apart from these, there are several thousand small factories with 4 or 10 looms. In some industries, machines have been imposed. They are using electricity and they are using some other means of energy. In the early years, the cotton textile industry was concentrated in the cotton growing belt of Maharashtra and Gujarat. Generally, cotton industries are established in the area of Maharashtra and Gujarat. Main states where cotton is produced, they are Maharashtra, Gujarat and Tamil Nadu also. In these parts, cotton is produced there. In some